Hello friends, I am Sanjay Gupta. I welcome you on Sanjay Gupta Tech School. In this video, I am going to demonstrate how you can control or implement organization level security in your org. So in my previous video, I gave you introduction related to that. But in this video, I will show you the demonstration as well. Before starting, if you want to watch more Salesforce training videos, you can go to description of this video. And you will find links of various playlists. Those playlists contain videos related to Salesforce, so you can watch them too. So now one by one, I'm going to cover all these three points. So first I'm going to show you how you can maintain a list of authorized users. So if you go to your org and in setup, if you type users, so it will show you all available or active users, admin users, and you can create new users, you can reset your passwords, you can deactivate a particular user. So here you can see with this list view, you can filter active users, admin users, and all users. So this is the list of users that is available in a particular org. Then if you want to click new, if you want to create new user, you can click on new user, fill all the required fields and click on save. So whatever email you will mention here, so a verification mail will be sent to that email ID and that user can set the password. Then if you want to reset password for a particular user, so you can check this checkbox and click on reset password. So reset password email will be sent. So this way you can manage the users. Now if you want to open record of a particular user, so here you can see all the details are available and the related lists. So here also you can see edit, sharing, reset and freeze buttons are available. So you can apply as per the requirement. Now, next is set password policies. So that we can apply on profiles. So now I'm going to search for the profiles. So whenever we create a user in our org, so we need to assign profile. So that is a required field. So if we see here, so you can see this user is having a profile as standard user. So let me open standard user profile. So you can open any profile. So all the profiles contains all the things mentioned here. So initially it is showing profile details, then console settings and page layouts, but we need to focus on the password policies and limit login to certain hours and locations so that we can set the IPs and limit the time at which users can log in. So that is available at the bottom of the profile page. So if you want to learn more about the profiles and permission sets, so I have created one more video related to that. So you can go through with that. So here you can see, yeah, these are password policies. So you can click on edit. Again, you need to scroll down and here you can see. So you can select these fields as per the requirement. So user password expires and enforced password history, minimum password length. So this way you can read the label and accordingly you can behave. So these all fields are related to password policies. So whatever password policies you set on this profile, so the users which are related to this profile, so these policies will be applicable to all those users, right? So I'm clicking on cancel. So this way I demonstrated you from where you can set password policies. Now we need to see limit login to certain hours and locations. So we can limit IP addresses from which users can log in, and we can also limit the times at which users can log in. So we have these two settings again in the profile. So if you scroll down, so just after the password policies, you will see these two options, login hours and login IP ranges. So if I click on edit on login hours, so you can set login hours for particular days, start time, end time. So this way you can set start and end time for this particular profile. So login hours will be set for this particular profile users. And Third is limit IP addresses. So that is also available in the profile page. So if we go here and if we click on new, so here you can set start IP address, end IP address. So this way you can set login IP ranges. So enter the range of valid IP addresses from which users with this profile can log in, right? So this way you can control users from org level, so that you can set the organization level security. And remember that these things you need to apply on the profile. So whatever changes you do for a particular profile, so those changes will be applicable for all the users associated with that profile, right? So this is all about organization level security. If you want to know about object level security, field level security, record level security, so you can go to description of this video, and there will be a playlist related to data security in Salesforce. So you can go through with this playlist. So you can see all the videos related to data security there. So I hope you understood whatever I demonstrated in this video. Thank you for watching this video.